Hello, my name is Rainer Hanekamp. This is Engineers with the latest updates from the Angular community every week. When using or trying to use AI in development, we are very often confronted with uncertainties. Not just that the AI lies to us, also known as hallucinations. Very often, even simple tasks take a lot of frustrating iterations and then still don't deliver satisfying results. On the other hand, we're also very often told that our prompts are just not good enough. Younes Jaaidi has now published a video that sets expectations right. It's almost like a live coding session where you see the same challenges in real time, how he deals with them, and how he structures this process. Younes calls his approach chartered coding. He splits the development process into stages, and for each stage defines a different ratio of manual versus AI-generated work. The planning phases, writing design docs and specifying tests, require the most manual effort. It's a feature-rich video with a lot of practical insights and tips and tricks. Speaking of AI, the Angular team has published a set of best practices instructions that you can use as a context for your prompt. While most are common sense coding standards, one aspect stands out. They encourage you to prefer reactive forms over template-driven ones. Michael Hladky from Push-Based is well known in the community for his work and talks about performance. He has now published a 3-article series on server-side rendering and incremental hydration. He explains how they work, how they integrate with browser rendering, and what their impact is on core web vitals. At the time of this recording, the full series is already available. Evgeniy, also known as Oz, published a deep dive article where he explains the relationship between reactivity and Angular's rendering model. He explains why signals outperform observables and emphasizes the importance of immutable state changes, again, for performance. And that's it. I wish you a nice week. See you in the next episode. Goodbye.